tri-city of Dammam, Dharan, and Al-Khobar is the commercial and political center of the Eastern Province. On a three-dimensional map, looking from the sea, the area looks like this. Khobar, Dharan, and Dammam. The oil strike at Dammam Well No. 7 in 1938 led to large-scale development in the Eastern Province. Indeed, the Eastern Province sits on the most extensive oil reserves anywhere in the world. But before the oil was discovered, Khobar was a small pearling and fishing village. The brothers Al-Ghazabi, pearl merchants, examining their stock in 1935, they remain an influential family in the area. Khobar is no longer a small village, but a bustling shopping center. Not exactly a match for Dubai, but less money was spent here on development than in Riyadh and Jeddah. Yet there are a number of shiny new malls. Largest, newest, and poshest is the Al Rashid, and it's packed at the weekends. The clock tower marks the center of scruffy downtown Khobar. Yet Khobar has never been overly picturesque. King Saud Street was the happening place in the early 50s. Now it's King Khalid Street. Shops are open in the mornings and from 4 p.m. to 9 or 10ish, but everything closes for prayers, for example, the sunset prayer, which usually coincides with the time you arrive in town to do some shopping or to eat. Shula Mall, it was a red hot favorite. That is, until... Of course, few, if any, shopkeepers were insured. This is part of the landscaped coastal road known as the Corniche. A good place to meet people, so I'm told, and home to a number of mosques. The Meridian Hotel, the poshest in the area. The post-oil development includes wide expressways and flyovers. However, improved roads haven't led to improved driving skills, but faster driving with no thought of consequences, although the consequences can often be seen. The roadside is neatly manicured, and the trees have interesting decorations. One peculiar feature of Saudi Arabia is the intersection art. Statues of people are un-Islamic, but abstract is okay. This may be a robot vacuum cleaner in the Jetsons. The space shuttle at the Silver Towers intersection commemorates the first Saudi in space. Officially, the population of Khobar is 100,000. It seems a conservative estimate, and as the average Saudi woman has 6.5 children, more and more houses are being built as Khobar expands into the desert. Khobar Towers, built from a 60s East European design, or so it seems. It was for the Bedouin, but being nomads, they weren't keen to live in tower blocks. It does, however, house, amongst others, the US military, and was bombed in 1996. Dharan is not really a city, but a combination of three institutions: Saudi Aramco, Dharan International Airport, and KFUPM, that is King Fahad University of Petroleum and Minerals. The campus occupies a prominent position on top of a limestone jebel, or hill. Founded in 1963, it is, in theory, meant to prepare Saudi students to work in the country's oil and gas industries. Dharan is the headquarters of the Arabian American Oil Company, Aramco, which, since 1980, has been wholly government-owned and is now known as Saudi Aramco. The Dharan camp is a self-contained and enclosed urban entity. The first geologists stepped ashore in 1933, and the camp was established near Dharan Hill, a geologically promising feature. And later, the camp became known simply as Dharan.
For free, but you can give them to the birds and bees. I want money.
allowed to drive on camp, but it's not worth buying a good car. This explains the phenomenon of the camp car. At Christmas, in true American tradition, many houses are decorated with lights. Off the coast of the Eastern Province is the island state of Bahrain, just 15 kilometers wide and 48 kilometers long. It is now linked to Saudi Arabia by the King Fahad Causeway. At 25 kilometers, it is the longest causeway but one in the world. It cost $1.2 billion, took 4 years to build, and was opened in November 1986. It spans the shallow sea with 5 bridges and reclaimed land, including the artificial island for the customs post.
I want to break free. I want to break free. I want to break free from your lies. You're so self-satisfied, I don't need you. I've got to break free.
Bahrain is a popular weekend destination, especially for those with multi-exit and entry Saudi visas. But why is it so popular? Oink! Well, there's the Seif Mall, with its multiplex cinema and modern Western shops.
Baby, now I got the flow, 'cause I know it from the start. Baby, when you broke my heart,
The relatively large population of the eastern province is only possible by virtue of the triumph of technology over harsh conditions, and of course, the petrodollars to pay for that technology. Much of the drinking water is expensively desalinated seawater produced in plants such as this. Along the coastal plain, wind blows the whitish sand southwards. Winter rain revives the perennial shrubs, producing this type of vegetated sandy terrain, known locally as dikaka. Further inland, the Darna sands are characterized by high, pinky brown dunes. And this isn't even the area known as the Empty Quarter. That lies further south and is even emptier. Dust storms, or shamals, are fairly common. But in the summer, if it isn't windy, then it's usually very humid. Take your choice. The Aramco Beach at Ras Tanura. Half Moon Bay lies to the south of Dharan. It's a popular outdoor recreation area for locals, and indeed expats. Moon Bay has some very interesting kiosk and cafeteria designs. As Saudi swimwear conventions differ to those in the West, there are a few private beaches, including the British Aerospace Beach and the Aramco Beach. Mm-hmm. Although the water is only 6 meters deep, very salty and very warm, dolphins can sometimes be seen. There are places to hire quad bikes and jet skis. Great fun. There are also races and daredevil displays on the dunes, in practice for driving home later. Many are not adverse to driving their four-door family saloon cars up a sand dune. Why not? Azazir Beach Market is set up on the shores of a small, shallow seawater lake just south of Azazir British Aerospace Compound. It's a very popular place at the weekends, with hundreds, if not thousands, of cars hurtling down the expressway just before dusk to have a picnic, ride a camel or horse, or just to stroll around the stalls looking for that perfect gift. We'll be right back. This variety of lizard is called dub and is considered a delicacy and highly nutritious. Mm-mm. Hofuf, traditionally the chief town of inland Eastern Arabia. It's about 130 kilometers southwest of Dhahran. It was the center of the Eastern province until 1953, when the radical and economic changes of the oil era made the move to Dammam inevitable. It stands at the southwestern corner of the Hassa Oasis, one of the largest in the world. But the effect of an island of greenery in a desert has been diluted because half of the former cultivated area has been covered by new construction. The large farming area in Hassa is made possible by the immense volume of water issuing from subterranean rock strata. The water comes up in over 500 springs, linked by a communal irrigation system. This is the Thursday market, or Souk al-Khamis, in 1905, during the Ottoman rule. And in 1917, it was the hub of commercial life in Hofuf, and indeed still is. This is the Mosque of Ibrahim in the Turkish fort, built by the Ottomans in the 16th century. Thank you. Also on Thursday mornings in Hofuf, there's a camel and sheep market. When you buy a camel, how do you get it into the back of your pickup truck? Use a crane, of course. Beware of low-flying camels. Just east of Hofuf are the ancient wave-eroded gorges and caves of Jebel Kara.
temperature rises, and the meaning is oh so clear. 1001 yellow daffodils begin to dance in front of you, oh dear. Are they trying to tell you something? You're missing that one final screw. You're simply not in the pink, my dear. To be honest, you haven't got a clue. I'm going slightly mad. I'm going slightly mad. It finally happened. It finally happened. Whoa. It finally happened. I'm slightly mad.
Oh dear.
I'm one card short of a full deck. I'm not quite the shilling. One wave short of a shipwreck. I'm not my usual top pick. I'm coming down with a fever. I'm really out to sea. This kettle is boiling over. I think I'm a banana tree. It finally happened, happened, finally happened.
Accommodation is important, which is why most companies ensure their employees have the same standard of accommodation.
Thank you.
British Aerospace Beach at Half Moon Bay is walled off and private. There's scuba diving, a yacht club, a cafe, showers, and a nine-hole golf course with green greens. As previously mentioned, Half Moon Bay is only 6 meters deep, very warm in the summer and very salty. The visibility is also very bad, and the desert just continues under the sea. However, artificial reefs have been put down, including this old bus, and they have attracted a lot of life, such as these yellow bar angelfish, fish that expect to be fed. This sea snake's bite is deadly, but luckily they aren't aggressive and have very small mouths. But they have killed fishermen when they've been caught up in their nets. industrial city of Jebeil is about an hour's drive north of Dharan. The desert island of Jerayd is 30 kilometers northeast of Jebeil, about 2 hours by boat. The diving isn't on a par with the Red Sea, but it's good for the Gulf. Favorite read is the Arab News, the Green Truth, especially the Islam in Perspective page, where the faithful have their queries answered. For example, are men superior to women? I find that most Muslims are convinced that there is a degree of superiority for men. Please comment. Well, Islam considers men and women equal in every respect. This equality is shown in the area of inheritance. What is left is shared equally by children on the basis of a son receiving twice as much as a daughter. Another problem. Is killing a non-believer allowed without any specific reason? Answer, it is forbidden, even if that person's a non-believer. A large quantity of t-shirts were confiscated recently because they had offensive writing on them. The offensive words included vixen, I am ready for sexual offers, charming, eccentricity, socialism, Christian, Bible, and Nike.